we came across Orica and Cyanco. They were quite supportive of our effort and want to see some innovative approaches to processing in the chemical space. And the US, Western US relies a lot on imports of sodium hydroxide. So what we're doing with Orica is really important. It's a really good step forward in our MOU with them.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Bill Willoughby. He is the CEO of Century Lithium. And Bill, great to see you again. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks, Steve. Great to be back with you again.
Yeah, I know you've got some news out. We'll talk about that in just a second. But for those who aren't familiar, just remind us a bit about the company itself and, more importantly, the project you're working on.
Oh, Century Lithium. We have our Angel Island Lithium project located in central Nevada, adjacent to the evaporation brine production of Silver Peak, which is an operation of Albemarle's. And we've been working on this project for about 7 years, working with an alkaline process to extract lithium from claystone, and our end product's going to be lithium carbonate. We've had a pilot plant operating down south of the project now for about 3 years, and we've been successful in producing battery-grade lithium carbonate at that plant.
Yeah, and you started from all the optimizing you've done into where you are today. You really got it to a refined product now, correct?
Yeah, we're quite happy with our process and all the different parts of it. Integral to the part of getting lithium to a final product in lithium carbonate, we use direct lithium extraction, a DLE process, which is really based on ion exchange absorption. Nothing really new there. It's worked quite effectively for us. We take the lithium in the claystone, we leach it with a alkaline process, use a hydrochloric acid. As part of that process, we make sodium hydroxide, which also happens to be the neutralizer that we use in the process. So,
and so brings us to today, and you've got news out that you've signed a memorandum of understanding with Orica Specialty Mining Chemicals. So tell me a bit about this company and why you put this together.
Well, Orica is a major chemical company. Worldwide, they're based out of Australia. They have sales everywhere, and they're about a $6 billion market cap company in the U.S. They own a company, Cyanco. Cyanco is important to the state of Nevada in that they supply chemicals to the mining industry, particularly the gold mining industry. They've got a plant located for us up in Winnemucca, Nevada, and they are one of the bigger consumers in the Western U.S. of sodium hydroxide. So as we were looking for a market to take care of our byproduct, we make about 40% surplus sodium hydroxide out of the process. We came across Orica and Cyanco. They were quite supportive of our effort and want to see some innovative approaches to processing in the chemical space. And Western U.S. relies a lot on imports of sodium hydroxide. So what we're doing with Orica is really important. It's a really good step forward in our MOU with them.
Yeah, and this is a five-year deal and potentially for five more after that. Obviously, there's been a change in government in the U.S. and they're talking about the importance of projects like yours. So are you feeling that as well, Bill? And an agreement like this really puts you into another level for sure.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, it definitely shifts the perspective of planning stage to more looking at the details in the ways of transportation and marketing and getting us off the ground. So that it is a big step forward for us.
Yeah. So let's talk about next stages. What can people expect in 2025, Bill?
Well, we are working on some optimization steps down at the pilot plant, and we'll be looking forward towards our permitting process, looking at all the aspects of transportation, and there's some interesting things on the processing side. So we've got a lot on the table, a lot of things on the go. You know, we're being very cash conscious at the present time in the market because lithium prices are depressed, but we see that coming back. And when it does, we'll be there.
All right, we'll leave it there. Bill, look forward to more conversations this year for sure. Thanks very much and congratulations on the deal.
Okay, well, thank you, Steve. It's good talking with you again.
All right, Bill Willoughby, the CEO of Century Lithium.